I will just give a basic understanding of my topic. I'm just describing the whole process which I adopted for the understanding of incised plaster work. Actually, I started with the scientific understanding, but when we went to site, we started exploring the monuments with incised plaster work. We came to know it is only scientific understanding is not sufficient to understand the incised plaster work. It is better to really first understand what is incised plaster work, how it is evolved over the time period, and what is the condition, and then look for the scientific investigation of the incised plaster work. Whenever we go and see the Delhi monuments, we really look at the dome, we look for the walls, types of arches, type of finishing, and type of different architectural element. But we really, we rarely spend much time on the decorative patterns, especially we don't differentiate between different types of decorative features and how they are very important for when we are looking for the thinking about the conservation. And if we really want to understand the monument, we really need to understand each and every element in totality and how the culture of decoration of Islamic monuments of Delhi really affected the whole overall composition of the monument. And firstly, I had a challenge to really define what is incised plaster work, because there are a number of times we get confused with the stucco work. So we clearly surveyed all the monuments, and we could find out a certain kind of variety, certain type of decorative lime plaster, which seems to, we really don't know what was the original method of making incised plaster work, but it seems to be it was done using cut work. Some certain layer of lime plaster was applied, and designs were transferred over that, and then it the patterns were prepared over that by cutting out the pattern. But at the when we look at the practicality, then another question arises. So I will just go through the different documentation and different understanding which we have developed. The process which I adopted. We have done the archival study. We have listed, we have taken out all the listed monuments which were listed from the 20th century by and till today. And we started looking at the photographs. We started looking at the, we started reading the description. The first good description really referred to Zafar Hassan, which was describing early 20th century monuments and telling about the incised plaster work. We prepared a list about more than 150 monuments of Delhi, which were described to have incised plaster work in Delhi. When we started the survey of those monument, and we could find out only till now, it may be more, but we could document only 60 structure. We still have incised plaster work, but after completing our report, we could find out more monuments which has incised plaster work. After doing this study, we really arranged all the monuments in the chronological order so that we can understand what was the time span when incised plaster work was done in that time period, so that we can understand the overall development, evolution of the patterns. Based on our studies, we really collected some. We could manage to collect some sample with the help of Archaeological Survey of India, and then we did a scientific investigation to find out the material composition, and then also we assessed the present status of the art. When we look at the timeline of Delhi, and based on our survey from the archival records, whatever listing was done before, and we could find out the time span of the incised plaster work was from Khilji to early Mughal. It was, we don't find really any example of incised plaster work after that. The time period was from first example which we noted is 1287, and the last example which we are finding is 1652. The monument which is on 1652, it is only on papers. When we look at the monument, it does not have any incised plaster work at present. The first monument of is Balwant's tomb, which we have in the Mehrauli Archaeological Park, and last surviving remains of the incised plaster work is Kuli Khan's tomb. This is the first building in Delhi where we get the incised plaster work along with the turquoise blue tiles. Surprisingly, we did never imagined we will get the very good results of incised plasterwork from the Tughlaq period. After looking at the profile and looking at the decorative patterns, it was really have evolved during the Tughlaq period. And we find all type of incised plasterwork during this period. Especially because Firoz Shah Kotla, we could locate only one remain there. But it needs more investigation to find out more details about it. Then Syed Monument, it was a transition period where it is the first example where we get the intricate plaster work. The broad forms from the Tughlaq period were converted into intricate patterns, and that you will find the design which were later converted into stone carving you find in incised plaster work. And the most significant time period is the Lodhi time period, where we get most of the structure which has fantastic quality of lime work, in which the most important mosque, the structure is Lodhi Mosque, which is in Lodhi Garden. It is one of the best example of the incised plaster work in India. This is all the listed monuments of Lodhi period. And similarly, we also get examples in early Mughal time period. But if we look at the sectional specification of the work from Tughlaq to early Mughal, after that we pick up the different elements and we studied the different kind of ceiling patterns. In all those time period, we get incised plaster work, very prominent medallion over the ceiling of the monuments, which itself evolved from Tughlaq period to Mughal time. I have done the whole study, but I'm just showing what was in the research area. And besides that, we have really prepared a evolution pattern of medallions from Tughlaq time period to Mughal, and we could find out there are certain patterns were repetitive overall from Tughlaq period to early Mughal, and even with the dome ceiling pattern, there were repetition of the pattern, and calligraphy inscription were also used in the medallions. This is the incised plaster bands which were used using Arabic pattern as well as calligraphic pattern. This is a different main component of the incised plaster work: arabesque, geometrical pattern, vegetable form, and floral forms. And calligraphy, we get Quranic inscriptions, we have hadith, and we have poetry and inscription in incised plaster work. Arabesque pattern is the most prominent example is Lodhi Mosque and Syed period monuments. And it is very surprising to see even 3 to 4 mm thick incised plaster work was done in these buildings without any kind of failure, without any kind of flaws into that. These are different borders which were done in different time periods and the geometrical patterns. It is an overview of showing different types of incised plaster work. And evolution of calligraphic pattern is very interesting, especially in case of incised plaster work. We find Kufi, Nux, Tulut, even we get the Nastaliq script, which is very difficult to craft over the stone. But we in Delhi, we have 3 examples of this kind of script in incised plaster work. And this is the last recorded building which in historic records we get this building had incised plaster work. But now it looks like the bottom, you can see the last image. And we also tried to analyze the survival of this art was for a particular time period. Later on, stucco work was introduced and more design were transferred into the stones. But we really find a discontinuity of the tradition for a long time period. And we really don't find any craftsman who traditionally was practicing this art. And the freehand caliber of the artist was nowadays took over by printing press. Now we are working on the computers. We are tracing and transferring those patterns on the stone and the lime work. But previously, it was really designed by the artists of the Karkhana, which were established by Mughal artisans. And we also have done the study of the archival records. We try to find out what was the management system for really doing the decorative art of this beauty. And we could find out there was a Karkhana system, Imarat Khana, which used to really take artists from different karkhanas, like calligraphy karkhanas and Arabis pattern, which were used for the weaving and other textile. All those artists were used to design decorative patterns for the buildings. Even the calligraphers, they normal people were not involved. The people who were well-established calligrapher, those people were hired for the calligraphic designing and executing the calligraphic pattern over the buildings. And it was a chain of transmission. The guru and chela system was working for the that has produced a very good quality of calligraphers that time. And 10 to 12 years training was essential for the calligraphers before practicing over the buildings or another medium. And we also did the study of material, and we did the visual inspection on the site, as well as we did the scientific investigation. IIT Chennai was helping us in doing the sample study. We studied 7-8 samples we could analyze, and we found that the main component of this material was the lime, and it is very difficult to imagine that lime was used, and we don't find any cracks, any flaws. There was no treatment sign. So we are really now, when we see the way, now you see the designs here, it is very difficult to make in lime without any cracks and without any kind of after surface treatment. But it is very surprising that after that we started reading the lime proportions specification, which is over the time period have evolved. We really don't get all those kind of specification. Even plain lime plastering, which we are doing nowadays, it is it is not matching with the original lime works. And this is the present state of the art. We don't have people who are really working. There is no patronization of this kind of art, which is completely stopped. People very work on the contract basis. And the kind of material, which best quality of material was used for this kind of process, that is, that practice is not there. Now, whatever is material, we have to produce from there. And the craftsmen, we consider the lime craftsmen from Rajasthan, so your work is very good. But there are certain discontinuity of the tradition which we need to understand before its application in such kind of conservation work. And you will find there several cases, you will find the people who are working in POP and finishing work, they are doing artistic work. Even they are practicing in different material. Now they are hands on really practice with the POP work and working with the mold system. They are not comfortable doing the freehand work. And this is a state of the work, line work we are thinking about. It is very difficult. We have to really work out specification. We have to work out very critical study of our existing incised plaster work. Before doing its conservation, we need to understand their basic material composition and the construction technique before entering into their conservation work. And my research ends with our critical points. Are we really capable of doing this kind of work at present stage? We really need to find out the gaps before its application in conservation work. Thank you so much.